Welcome this afternoon for the Dynamics 365 Business Central update. My name is William, as Anne introduced me. I'm the Partner Technology Strategist at QBS Group and also the Product Specialist for Business Central. Like Anne mentioned, this webinar is after Directions in North America, so we will cover a lot of the news which was spread over there. And the goal is, of course, to inform you about the latest news regarding Business Central. And a few topics we are going to cover in this session is the roadmap, of course, also the priorities for the fiscal year 2020 for Microsoft, and one of the new goals for Microsoft is to improve the partner capability. And yes, a certification is on its way. So that's great news for our partner channel. And we will cover something about the AppSource marketing requirements. Of course, some what's new topics regarding Business Central, which is available within the April release and which was actually shown at Directions. And of course, all the other news like the new announced licenses, internal use rights, and many more. And in case you missed it, please have a look at our YouTube channel for the great videos our colleague Herman and Nelson covered, which includes the highlights of Directions in several videos for every day. With that, let's start with the roadmap. This is the roadmap I showed you in the last webinar and which was shown on Directions Asia. And for some of the partners out there in the channel, it was quite a shock that Microsoft officially announced after some rumors that per October 2019, Business Central will be AL only and also modern client only. Roadmap at Directions North America didn't change much from the roadmap on Directions Asia, but the new info, as you can see at the top of the slide, which we have taken a picture of, it said that the April release of Business Central, the April release of 2019, of course, will remain available to sell until October 2020. So you as a partner are able to sell the April release, so on-prem with Seaside until October 2020. And also, of course, that includes the Windows client. And next to that, Microsoft will, somewhere in the next month, will share us the target release notes for the target new features for the October release with us. So which when they come out, we will definitely share them with you guys. The fiscal year 2020 priorities for Microsoft regarding the business applications are mainly land, expand, and build. That was the message which was shown at the keynote in Las Vegas. And it's clear that they want to land new cloud customers. So Microsoft, of course, it's all cloud, cloud, cloud. So they want to migrate the on-prem base. And to make that easier, maybe you've heard about the Cloud Sync tool we had in the past to sync your data from of on-prem to the cloud to get the AI functionality and so on. That tool will be improved or is already improved to use it as a officially migration tool for going on-prem to the to a Business Central SaaS. In expanding a phase, they want to grow the users and usage, of course. Like you could imagine, if you have Office 365 and Business Central, please use also Power Apps. And by the way, we also have some different license plans for Power Apps. So that's the grow Microsoft has as in his vision, and also to cross-sell those workloads. And more important for you guys is that they definitely want to build the partner ecosystem. They heavily rely on the partners in the Dynamics channel, and they want to improve the capabilities of those partners, which is more or less the certification. We will come back to that later. And also some activation and a code sell program with the ISVs, and I will cover that later on in this webinar also. Microsoft wants to do some investments to grow your skills, and to do that they give every Dynamics partner free and unrestricted access to the DLP and Microsoft Learn, which is the new name of the platform, which is accessible through partners.microsoft.com. Next to that, they have created a YouTube channel especially for Business Central. We already had a Dynamics E65 channel, but now we have a dedicated channel for Business Central with some great videos, and I will show something in a minute. And of course, the complete ready-to-go program, which is accessible on the web publicly. And to be honest, the materials they are sharing there are very great. And maybe you remember the playbook I showed you in one of the last update calls. It's also available over there. Next, the investment of Microsoft that drive partner differentiation and the customer success. It's based on the feedback of both partners and end customers. That end customers are looking for the best partner, and if you are a great partner, but you think of yourself and you want to go out to the market and say, okay, I'm certified. The last few years that wasn't possible with especially with Business Central. And Microsoft announced that there will be a new certification exam for Business Central somewhere in fiscal year 2020. So that could be this calendar year or next calendar year, we don't know. And it will, at first, it will be a role-based exam for functional consultants. And one of the guys over there in Las Vegas mentioned that they raised the bar considerably, also based on the feedback of both end customers and partners, that they say, okay, everybody could say I'm certified, so what's the value of this certification? So Microsoft has raised the bar, as they said. They want to give you some other opportunities to differentiate you out in the channel. Also announced for the fiscal year 2020 that there will be two competences. One is the cloud business application, and the other one is the small and mid-market cloud solutions competency. And we don't have any more information yet, but those are the two options to differentiate you out there in the channel. And if Microsoft comes with more information regarding the program and how to get it actually, we of course will share it directly to you. Last but not least, they give the partners a rich set of telemetry-based indicators that provide better business insights. And that one is already live in Partner Center. And there you have the capability as a partner to analyze the subscription usage, license users, Azure users in Partner Center of all your customers, and you can take some actions proactively. Like I mentioned before, Microsoft has created a new dedicated YouTube channel, especially for Business Central. And 2 or 3 days ago, at the start of Direction, I guess, they added some new videos. And there are some great examples you should definitely watch. Of course, you have the What's New Business Central, the application, also the What's New Business Central platform. But please also have a look at the connecting Power Apps and Flow to Business Central. Like I mentioned before, you sell Business Central, for example, but you also have the opportunity to use the power of Power Apps and Flow, which is already within the platform. And there is a great introduction video for that out there on the channel, which is hosted by Aaron John. Most of you will know them. And it's a great introduction video to use both Power Apps and Flow in combination with Business Central. It's a low level introduction. So if you're completely new to the Power Platform, that doesn't matter. It's a great introduction video. And if you want to learn more, you could always join the Ready to Power program we offer at QBS. Another great example is the video which is out there on the channel regarding Business Central and AI, which is more or less a marketing term. We have AI. Yeah, what are the capabilities and opportunities by using it? It's a great video on with some examples how to actually use AI within Business Central, which is already there in the default standard Business Central application as you get it from Microsoft, and also some introduction on the code units, how to use and create your own AL extensions using the same libraries for creating your own business logic. And maybe you already are familiar with the App in a Day training we offer at QBS Group. It's good to know that we also have Flow in a Day and AI in a Day. So those are great trainings for you if you want to learn more about this. Next up, some completely different subject. That's the submitting of an application to AppSource. Of course, those ISVs which are working on putting their application on AppSource, there will be some struggling. And Microsoft has created a video with the top five mistakes people made when they are submitting their app for a publication on AppSource. And it's a great time saver to invest 3, 4, or 5 minutes watching this video and avoid making the same mistakes. And to mention a few, if you're publishing your app on AppSource, you have to mention the countries you are available, and also the versions of Business Central you support. So if it's using Business Central Essentials or the premium license. Also, a big number of partners or ISVs don't follow the branding guidelines by using the wrong logos, the wrong naming, and so on. And it's also good to know that you have to have an entry point for your end users as an ISV of your solution, to that you need to have two different entry points, one for product help and one for support. And so, yeah, like I mentioned, please have a look at this video. It's 5 minutes of your time, and it saves you a lot of time for resubmitting an app through AppSource. Next up, some new features which are available within the April release. And maybe it's good to know that if you're facing some problems with updating the April release or using the April release, please know that you're not the only one. There are some known issues, like Microsoft has stopped or paused the update process from Business Central Fall 18 release to April release. But it is possible to create a sandbox with the April release. And there are some other issues like that the search button completely disappeared since yesterday. So yeah, there are some issues. Please know that you're not the only one. And now back to the subject, what's new? And this is more or less it's not a joke, but they worked on the performance and stability. And like I mentioned before, they have added some telemetry to detect configuration errors for you as a partner, automated logging, improved error messages, and maybe you've experienced it already by yourself. We were used to error messages back in NAV that, yeah, which said, okay, something went wrong, and that's it. Now they also tell you what is wrong on which page or which which record or whatever. They also did a lot of bug fixing within the April release, but like I mentioned before, today we also have some bug issues, but for sure they're going to fix that. And also a great enhancement is that they are able to reduce the number of inactive session timeouts. Those are just a few enhancements related to the performance and stability of Business Central. And now I will cover some new features. One of the new features is the view time information on the registers. You can now view time information on, for example, the GL register, item register, and also for jobs. And this allows you to find transactions in faster, not just by date, but also by the time that the transactions were created. So it's a great feature for searching for something that caused an error or whatever. Next up is the new feature that it's possible to create a validate a quote valid to date on your quote. And with that, it's possible to yeah, use a date for your quote, and to make sure that the sales quotes which are expired, you have now the option to delete them. So that could also be done by a job queue, of course, but please also have a look for using Microsoft Flow, for example, that you create a flow that all the sales quotes with a expiration date 2 days upfront, please send them an email or whatever. So a great tool for the sales and marketing department in the for the end customers. The document attachments feature allows you to attach any type of file to a sales or a purchase document. And this is useful, for example, when settling vendor payments so that you can quickly view the original invoice. And now attachments on sales and the purchase documents can be viewed on the ledger entries also. And you can view them also on the apply entries page as you apply the payments to ledger entry. So a small but great announcement. When analyzing those ledger entries, it's useful to also see the item description, the customer name or vendor name, and the description and name fields can now be added to the ledger entries, such as the item ledger entries or the customer ledger entries. And it's possible by copy the item descriptions to entries checkbox, which is a setup, of course, on the inventory setup, and which is also the same for the sales and receivables setup, for the customer entries and also in the purchases and payable setup for copying the vendor name to the entries. It's a great addition. You can now schedule background jobs or reports by defining a date formula. So instead of defining a fixed day, for example, instead of running a report on every Monday, you can now define to run it at the beginning of each month by entering, for example, CM plus a D1, which means current month plus one day. So you define this in the next run date formula field on the job queue entry card or on the schedule report page, because it's possible for using both in job queues and also in the report page. In the last webinar, I also covered some news regarding the enhancements in RapidStart. And about migrating your data to Business Central with RapidStart services, it's of course useful to see the errors that occurred for a specific table within the configuration package. So that's very useful, because now you can see all the configuration package errors in just one screen. And of course you can open or edit them within Excel. And that's not only very useful for getting all the errors, but also to distribute them to the different consultants, for example, to fix them, or to distribute some errors back to the customer when they are delivering the wrong master data or whatever. And also a new feature, the dynamically set shortcut dimension columns. This is a great enhancement. Fields for the two global dimensions that you set up are always available on journal and document lines. And now they also added the shortcut dimensions that you define on the setup page. So if you add a new shortcut dimension, it will show up in the journal lines and on the documents. That were some great new features for Business Central, and now we also want to cover some other news from Directions North America. And the first one is that they announced a device license, which is available per 1st of July. And we don't have a euro price yet, but the dollar price will be $40 a month. And more information will be shared within the license guides, which for the month of July. So we have been, need to wait a few weeks, and then we get the more information about the requirements and so on for this license. And there are also some new announcements for the internal use rights. Per 1st of May, the quantity of the full users for partners have increased significantly. So, for example, a solution provider agreement, if you have that as a partner, you now get 15 seats. And if you have a MPN ERP Silver, for example, you now get 30. Good to know that this is only for Dynamics 365 Business Central on-prem. At the moment, there is no internal use rights license for the Business Central SaaS, and Microsoft is working on it, and the rumors are saying that we can expect something at July 1st, but yeah, we will see, and we have to wait for that, of course. And also some questions in the Q&A sessions at Directions. One of the questions was that, we can now use, of course, with Flow and Power, that we could use IoT devices, do they need a license? And the answer is yes, basically every person or device which modifies data needs a license. So a person, yeah, of course, a device, yeah, of course, and that's also for IoT devices. Another addition, it's not on the sheet, is that for Dynamics 365 Business Center on-prem, we also get the external accountant and the system administrator user back. These user types are included already in a subscription licensing model. And they now have been added to the perpetual licensing model for Business Center on-prem. And if you want to know more or get more information about that, you can have a look at the on-premises licensing guide. Next is the transition ratio. Based on partner feedback, the Dynamics NFV full user to Dynamics 365 Business Center on-premise full user ratio from 1 to 2 to 1 to 3. So for every one NFV full user, you get 3 Dynamics 365 Business Central full users, which are of course named users. And that's for each Dynamics NFV full user licensed before the 1st of May this year. And it's good to know that the Dynamics NFV customers who have already transitioned to Dynamics 365 Business Center on-prem, they will receive the additional user, so the one extra, via a license adjustment somewhere this month. And short note, this is also, of course, for the limited users. So full users, but also it's applicable for the limited users, which will get a team member license. Speaking about team members, it has not been clear up until today what you could do with a team member license, especially in the Business Central SaaS environment. We had the marketing materials that with a team member license, you're able to read anything and modify just customer, vendor, and items. So the master data, more or less. Approve tasks assigned to you. Create, edit, delete a quote, enter timesheets, and use Power Apps. These are more or less the possibilities and the capabilities while using a team member license. And again, I'm speaking about Business Central SaaS. Of course, you are also able to test the team member plan. So in a sandbox, you can act if you're a team member. So you can check if a certain activity could be done by using a team member license. One of the new adjustments is that with a team member license, you could also use extensions, but it's maximized at using 15 custom entities per session. So back in the NFV times, we had the limited user, which could use 3 tables per session. In this team member license, for extensions, you could use 15 custom entities per session. One small note, Microsoft is not capable to monitor it at the moment, so it will not be checked. But of course, you could imagine that somewhere in time, Microsoft has created something to check this. So please keep in mind that you're allowed to use 15 custom entities on a team member license. It's more or less critical information, especially for ISVs creating a solution for Business Central SaaS. You are able to use both Power BI, Power Apps, and Flow while using a team member license. But of course, the data you use within Power Apps or Flow or in Power BI is restricted by the license you are using. So if you, for example, have created a Power App where you could create and modify jobs, for example, in Business Central, that's not possible while using a team member license, because in Business Central you don't have the rights to create a job, for example. Also very important, a team member SaaS is not the same as a team member on-prem. Like I mentioned before, in NFV we had the limited user, and the on-prem license was previously called a limited user and is a different type of license. In NFV we had, like I mentioned before, with a limited user you were able to use 3 tables per session, and there was a list of tables which was excluded from this. The Business Central SaaS team member is only capable to do the actions which are shown at the top of this sheet. So basically read anything, modify existing data, and some personal stuff like approve tasks assigned to you and enter your timesheets and so on. As a team member plan cloud version is different from a team member license for on-prem, you cannot develop for both without considering what the plan, cloud, or the license for on-prem gives the user access to. If you have an on-prem add-on that works for the team member on-prem, and you want to move to cloud as an extension for Business Central SaaS, you will have to develop and test for the team member's cloud plan, because those are different types of team members. So that's a good point to keep in mind. And the team member's on-prem license gives full access to all tables, but only allows the user to write to 250 specific tables, something like that, and which are included plus the 3 additional optional tables. But once again, it's not the same. So if you develop a extension for which should be used by a team member, please keep in mind that a team member on Business Central SaaS is not the same as a team member on Business Central on-prem. Next up, the monetization of Marketplace. Marketplace is the platform, the cloud platform of Microsoft to transact IP of Microsoft itself, and of course for the IP of the ISVs. On the platform cloud marketplace, there is currently hosted the Azure Marketplace, but also AppSource. And AppSource is of course related to Business Central. And Microsoft will start with the monetization of Marketplace, where Microsoft will collect money and then distribute to the partners who own the app IP. So if you have an app and it's published on AppSource, you could choose as an ISV to let Microsoft transact the app for you. And to be able to do that, new AL commands will come shortly. And Microsoft offers both a per seat and a per site transactions capability. And of course that costs money, and the transaction fee will be 10%. And of course, I could imagine that there will be some changes to that, or some inclusions or exclusions, but yeah, I don't know. But at the moment, think of a transaction fee of 10%. And this method gives the Microsoft the possibility to start a IP co-sale program, where you could say, okay, When a end customer buys something in AppSource, it also gets some stuff from an ISV within it by selling a bundle, for example. So with this method, customers can buy an app in two ways: transacted by the publisher and listed in marketplace, which is more or less the current situation for AppSource. If you have an app for Business Central and you are listed in AppSource, which is a store on the cloud marketplace, you are listed, but you have to perform the transaction and also the provisioning by yourself. The new method is that the app will be transacted by Microsoft and also transacted through Marketplace. This will be available per 1st of July. And now there's the important part of this message. Microsoft is currently evaluating the inclusion of Business Central on this marketplace. Like I mentioned before, Marketplace is the platform, and on the platform is both Azure Marketplace and Microsoft AppSource. And of course, AppSource is related to Business Central and also other apps, but also Business Central. And they are evaluating the inclusion of Business Central. So, per 1st of July, this will work, but not for Business Central. We think that the most difficult part for Microsoft to make this happen is the transacting part for Business Central. And also, Microsoft is heavily relying on the Dynamics Partner Channel. Microsoft is not a direct seller for Business Central, and technically they are capable of selling Business Central directly, but they are not doing that at the moment. They are heavily relying on their Dynamics Channel. But you could imagine that somewhere in time they will include Business Central anyway. In the meantime, if you're interested in publishing your app or selling it through a volume market, please contact both or Herman or Nelson, our colleagues at QBS, and ask them about the QBS marketplace. Why? AppSource is more or less end customer focused. You, as an end customer using Business Central, could open up the Microsoft App Source and search or browse for new apps, just like you're doing on your Google Play or App Store on your iOS device. The QBS marketplace is focusing on Dynamics partners. Like, you sell Business Central and you want to sell also some add-ons. Maybe add-ons you own the IP of, but maybe you will sell some ISV solutions you don't have the IP of. That's the gap where the QBS marketplace comes in place. And like I said, if you're interested for the QBS marketplace, please contact Herman or Nelson. And also, please join the hot news session of next week. And I will come back to that later. Or ask us your questions at the QBShares, for example. Next week we have the QBShare in the Netherlands. Please ask us about this, because this is a very important topic, how to monetize your IP, which is somewhere on the marketplace. And especially when it's Business Central, because that's not included yet. If there are any new updates or any confirmations or whatever, we will publish them, of course, at first as at the QBS Partner Network on Jammer. So if you don't follow that already, please do so. And with that, I would say it is time for some Q&A. And do you have some questions?
Well, the questions that has been asked along the way has also been entered by the rest of the team in here. So if anybody wants to unmute and ask questions in voice, that's also fine. There is one from Kapil here. What is the transition ratio for ISV device Cal from perpetual to Dynamics 365 Business Central on-premise?
Yeah, a very good question. We don't know yet because that's something I forget to mention that the new license which was added, the device license for Business Central is only for SaaS at the moment, as we know. So we have to get some confirmation that it's also for on-prem, and we don't know if there is a transition ratio. And if so, yes, what it will be. So we don't know yet.
Yeah, and as Andy says here, it's also a good idea to check the videos that Herman and Nelson sent back from Directions. I know the first day may not have included that much, and they actually wrote us the first day, not that much news to share, but that certainly changed on day two.
And that's also regarding the marketplace and the new strategy of Microsoft of the monetization. So indeed.
There's also a question from Neil here. How can Dynamics GP customers migrate their licenses to Dynamics BC on-prem? Do we know?
Sorry,
So
I
it's a
didn't.
GP question.
Oh yeah, GP.
I have something here saying, William, that it says Dynamics GP customers with an active enhancement plan will be able to transition to Dynamics 365 Business Central on premises via license migration transition, the LMT.
Yes. There's a specific upgrade for that, which is effective, I thought, per 1st of July.
Yes. It says here, it just so you all know, we've been told that this will all be formally communicated from Microsoft tomorrow. So we just wanted to give you all a heads up here. So it should all be, with all the small letters and everything, should be communicated tomorrow.
Indeed. Also, there are also some new licensing guide for example, especially for the team members. And some of those documents are for internal use only at the moment from Microsoft, but they want to they will share them definitely by tomorrow. And are there any new questions?
Andrew is asking for anybody having experience with migrating customers from GP to Business Central. Brooke, do you have anyone in your region that has done this? Or Andy
No,
in UK?
not in Maya as of yet, but we do have a lot of GP partners here, so it's extremely topical.
Yeah, so we'll keep an eye out, Andrew, for anything on it.
And like I said before, if the official confirmations of all the news comes out by tomorrow or maybe the day after tomorrow, we will share them definitely with you guys on the partner network, and it will also be available in the partner portal, I guess. And like I said before, next week we also have the QB Share over here in the Netherlands, so please feel free to ask. And
There's a
just a
question,
small,
William.
yeah.
There's something about limited device Cal from BRL maps to one team member in BC on-prem, and Kapil ask, will this work for NAV Perpetual as well?
I don't know
I'm
about
answering
this.
that, don't
You're
worry.
Andy, okay.
I am, I'm on it.
Okay, great. And then I'm using the time to say that this morning we at QBS sended out a invitation for the hot news session, which covers all the news of Directions North America. And it said, okay, please join us next Tuesday, May 13. And of course, that should be Monday, 13 of May. So please join us on Monday. Any new questions in the moment?
No, not for now. No. But as always, questions can also be placed on the Yammer network.
Of course.
The whole team is picking up on those as well.
Definitely. Then I would like to thank you all for your time, and maybe we will meet in a short time, and otherwise we will come back to you with a new webinar next month.
Sure will. Thank you, William.